Salutations, friends. Welcome back to my channel. Today I wanted to have a little kind of talk video with you and tell you about my favorite YouTube fragrance reviewers. Now this is going to be a two-part video series, or a two-parter. The first one, today's video, I'm going to talk about my favorite female fragrance reviewers. Now these aren't going to be people who review female fragrances or, you know, feminine fragrances. These are going to be female reviewers like me. And the next video, I'm going to talk to you guys about my favorite male reviewers, my favorite reviewers that are guys, dudes, bros, girls, ladies are today. So if you want to know my favorite female YouTube fragrance reviewers, then keep watching. Okay, so if you're anything like me, you might be obsessed with watching fragrance reviews on YouTube. I spend so much time watching reviews. I love them. Old reviews from years ago, new reviews. I am obsessed with watching reviews. It's one of the reasons why I got into YouTube. Now, when I first started doing YouTube videos about 7 or 8 months ago, I primarily focused on skincare and beauty, and this channel is still going to be very focused on skincare and beauty because I am also kind of a skincare junkie, addict, obsessed, and I do like makeup, but I like to bring that to the table. But I wanted to slowly transition this channel to be skincare, beauty, and fragrances because I love fragrances. I'm obsessed. If you've watched my reviews, maybe you understand my obsession. But part of the thing that I love is like just watching what other people like, seeing what they don't like, just watching other people's passion and obsession. I really enjoy it. So I've been watching probably fragrance reviewers years before I even decided to start YouTube. So I have a few favorites, a few ones that aren't around anymore, one very specific person that's not around anymore, which breaks my heart and is a huge loss to the YouTube fragrance community, and some up-and-comers that just are just like storming the front, taking over, getting tons of subscribers and review and people who are coming to them for reviews. I mean, like, I'm seeing some up-and-comers, some fan favorites, all the buzzwords that people use. So I have my favorites. I have the ones that I subscribe to. I watch a lot of people, but I don't subscribe unless I love what you do. It's kind of like you have to earn my subscription. I will watch you. I will sit through your ads. That's the thing. Just about any video I watch, I will sit through ads. I hate it, but I know that that's how it helps other YouTubers. It's not subscribing, commenting helps, but for me, I sit through ads. So these are the people I'll sit through ads for, but I try to sit through ads for everybody. Off topic. So I wanted to also talk about what I look for in reviewers. So that way, when you see the people that I chose, you'll kind of understand. The two things I look for when I look for a fragrance reviewer is someone who I enjoy watching. So you have to be entertaining. And you can be entertaining from like a documentary educational standpoint. Like, I'm not saying you have to have so many different, like, your editing and sound effects and woo woo woo. Like, if you're coming at me like just talking like you're a friend or you're a teacher, I find that entertaining too. But I also like the woo woo woo, the lights and the bedazzled videos. And I want to see your passion. I really do. There's some fragrance people out there, a lot of the big beauty gurus who talk about fragrance, they're like, look at my collection. Oh, this one's so nice. And you know that they like perfume, and it's interesting to see what they enjoy, but I want to see a passion. I want to see someone who's obsessed. I want to see somebody who scrimps and saves for that bottle or has to decide between 5 different decants because they've limited themselves to 5 decants a month and they just couldn't decide and they're going crazy. Like, I want to see your passion. I want to see your obsession. That doesn't mean that you have to have a lot of bottles in your collection. That doesn't mean that you have to have the most expensive fragrances. That doesn't mean that you have to only, like, review niche brands or high-end brands. Like, you can have a passion for the lower end. You can have a passion for body mist. You can have a passion for celebrity fragrances. You can have a passion for Victoria's Secret fragrances. I love watching those videos because, like, before I used to not take those seriously, and now I do. Like, my worldview to other fragrances has been opened because of the passion of other fragrance reviewers. And I love that, and I thank them for that. So this video is going to be the fragrance reviewers that I just think you can see their passion, you can see their obsession, they're entertaining, they're informative, and they're pretty awesome. So I'm going to get into a little of each as to why I like them, and I'm also, you know, in the description box, I'm going to link them all below. I recommend checking out their channel, subscribing. If you do subscribe because of me, say hi for me. But in any case, like, these fragrance reviewers I think are fantastic and deserve a lot. First is going to be, I think, a fragrance reviewer that if you are a part of the fragrance community, you know her reviews, you love her, and you miss her dearly, and it's Katie Buckrick. Oh, she was so good! You guys, I will literally go back and rewatch her videos, like, all the time. Like, I just will go to her channel, miss her dearly, and just, miss her. I miss her so much. She, to me, is like what I would hope to ever be. It's just someone who is so knowledgeable, who's vivacious, who's funny, who's intelligent, who has an extreme passion for fragrance, and she just shares it with the world. I don't think anyone can watch her videos without having a smile on their face. She's just so funny. But like, her passion for fragrance is there in all of her videos, and that's why she became, I think, the most popular female fragrance reviewer on YouTube. Now sadly, she doesn't do videos anymore, which is really sad, but I wish she'd come back and just kind of do a check-in. But overall, like, she's fantastic. I love her channel. Even though she doesn't make videos anymore, guys, go check them out. They're so good. So Katie Buckrick is definitely my favorite female reviewer on YouTube. Another reviewer that I really like a lot, and she is just a rising star, is Tiff Benson. She is this ridiculously, like, bombshell gorgeous, like, beauty reviewer, but on top of for how beautiful she is, that is how intelligent and passionate she is about fragrance. And that's why I think she is so popular. She has this way of talking and about fragrances that just makes you fall in love with them over and over again. There's some fragrances that she's reviewed that I'm not a fan of, that I'm just like, you know, maybe I'll give them a second chance. She has a huge passion for fragrance. She is making her way, like, blowing down doors, like, coming into the fragrance community. She's blowing up, and she is definitely worth checking out. She does a lot of masculine fragrance reviews for men, fragrance reviews for women. She's very well-rounded, very intelligent, and again, very passionate about fragrances. And so I just love watching her channel, and I'm very excited to see her channel grow. Another super favorite of mine is Amy Loves Perfume. She is so wonderful. Okay, she has probably the most enviable collection I've ever seen. I love her haul videos. But what really made me fall in love with her is not just her passion for fragrance, because you understand it. I see her commenting on just about every fragrance video. She is so active in the fragrance community, specifically on YouTube, that I've seen. I just think that is wonderful. She's not just making content and sitting back and watching herself get tons of reviews and tons of views. She's really just a participant in this community, and I think that is so awesome. I also love the way that she reviews fragrances. She's like taking you on this journey when she's talking about fragrances. It's just this really beautiful, magical thing to listen to and watch. It's very enchanting, it's very entertaining, and I absolutely love her channel. Another favorite of mine, and you'll see me reference her a lot on here because we both have a love for gourmands, is Delicious Delights. Her channel, if you like gourmand fragrances, is probably the channel to go to on YouTube for gourmand fragrances. She has a very discerning nose. She has a beautiful channel. I love her Smelly Jar series. And when I say beautiful, you see how much she loves gourmands. You see the excitement in her eyes when she's like, you know, when she does the videos with her husbands and she's like doing the blind sniffs and she smells one and you see, like, what she really likes the fragrance, her eyes kind of light up. It's wonderful to watch. I love seeing that. I love seeing people's genuine just excitement over fragrance, even if it's a fragrance that they smelled over and over and over and over again. I love her channel. She's definitely one to watch out. Smelly Jar videos I particularly like because they're kind of off the grid. They're a little bit different and they go into a different realm of fragrance. She talks about weirdest perfumes, scrubbers. It's just like, it's a different experience than the normal, this is a review, this is a list, here's Aventus, you know? Like, it's a different way to get into fragrance videos. It's entertaining, it's fun, and the passion is real with that one. And I absolutely love her videos. Another one of my favorite YouTubers is Vava Couture. I love her videos. She is so spunky and fun, and her videos are ridiculously well edited. But what I love about her videos is like how she reviews and shares her passion. It's literally like cut to the bone. This is what I like. This is what I don't like. Yeah, you know, just like it's quick. It's easy, it's informative, but it's entertaining. You could watch her like videos for hours and like learn something new, even if it's about a fragrance you've been wearing for years. You can develop a new love for fragrances you didn't like before, kind of like Tiff Benson. The way she describes fragrances, even fragrances I don't like, I'm like, maybe I should give that another chance. And you kind of see some of these fragrances in a new light. I also just love how she takes herself seriously while not taking herself seriously. And I think that's so refreshing to see. Sometimes some reviewers take themselves way too seriously, they're a little bit too dry, and the fact that she is so silly and so fun and so spunky in her videos while still getting to the point, explaining the fragrances, and you can generally see her passion for fragrances and perfumes in her videos as well. I think it's just a beautiful mix of just really a lot of fun. Like, her videos are super fun to watch. I love them. I get really excited whenever I see she has a new video up. So Vava Couture, I absolutely adore. She's very spunky and fun, but most importantly, the way she talks about fragrances, the way she reviews fragrances, I think is spot on. Next up is Fragrance Oasis with Waha. She is so fun! Okay, she is another just boom in the fragrance community. She has this energy and this vivacity about her reviews I love. She reviews men's fragrances, she reviews women's fragrances, she reviews niche, she reviews inexpensive, she pretty much does it all. She is very passionate, very serious about fragrance while still being entertaining and fun to watch. I think she is definitely, if you are unsure if who to follow and you have to only follow one of these guys, I think she is so well-rounded in all of her reviews and how she talks about fragrance. I think she is just fantastic. I love her energy. She makes me laugh more often than any other fragrance reviewer. My sides were splitting in a few of her, what was her video? I have it open here. I think it was like the trends to ditch in 2017. And the fragrance, like fragrance trends to ditch. And it's like, I think she was talking about like mispronouncing, and that's my biggest problem. I know I need to work on that. Is mispronouncing names, mispronouncing brands, mispronouncing ingredients. I need to work on my pronunciation. And I was just kind of like so tickled because I was just like, that's me. That's so me. I'm so bad. I need to work on that. And I just, it was comical. I didn't feel bad about the video. I just felt bad about that. I'm so bad. But it's just like her, the whole video, she didn't take herself seriously. She was so funny. And that's what I love about her channel. You see her energy, and that energy isn't just an energy she puts on for the camera. That's an energy that she has about her passion for fragrances. And I love that. So I definitely, definitely think if you could only really check out one of these guys, I would definitely check her out. Because I just think she's so well-rounded in all the reviews that she does and everything that she talks about while still being entertaining, funny, and just having this ridiculously, vivaciously infectious passion for fragrance. I love it. I know, there's a lot of these, you guys. I think there's only two or three more. Another one of my favorite fragrance reviewers that I've really recently just got into watching, and she's super great, is Smurfy Girly. She has this beautiful, beautiful way of talking about fragrances. I just like sitting and listening to her talk. It's kind of meditative or meditative. As you know, I can't pronounce words. I just love sitting and listening to her talk. I kind of will put her videos on if I'm working on art and just listen to her in the background. Like, I'm listening and I like hearing what she's talking about, but I take it all in, and then I'll like go and I'll rewatch the video a little bit later, and it's just I love it. She's very, I don't want to say she's cold. She's not cold at all, actually. She's quite funny, and she's quite vivacious. But I just love how she's just like talking to you, like kind of like You like this fragrance? Let me tell you why you like this fragrance. I don't like this fragrance. You know, I really love that. It's like you're talking with your friend, or you're talking with your mom, or your sister, or your best friend, and you're just like talking about, like, you're going out to eat or going out a few drinks, and you're like, yeah, I got this perfume. Oh, what do you like about it? I love that. It's very relatable. So I think she's absolutely fantastic, and I've recently been watching her videos, and I think I've binge watched like all of them. So yeah, this is saying something, but I do really enjoy Smurfy Girl. Eva in the City. I love, love Eva in the City. Eva in the City. She is so ridiculously just awesome to watch. Like, I love how she talks about fragrances. I love how she talks about luxury. She has this like ultra channel where you just want everything she has, but she's ridiculously down to earth about everything. She gets to the point. I loved it when she was walking through Harrah's and she went to Chanel and she was, you know, mixing the fragrances and learning about the fragrances. I love that. Whenever she talks about perfume, you guys, I stop what I'm doing and I watch her videos. If I'm driving, I'm like, okay, I'm gonna put this on in the background. Like, her videos are so entertaining to watch. I love the success she's been getting. I love how popular she's getting, and I think it's ridiculously well deserved. So I think that if you like luxury items, if you like fashion, if you love fragrance, she is a fantastic reviewer. And Pearl, I wanna say Pearl, she's a fantastic fragrance aficionado to watch. Okay, last but not least is Just Jell. I really like her energy. I think she is quirky and fun, and she has such, it's just like a breath of fresh air when I watch her videos. She's not afraid to tell you if she doesn't like something. She's not afraid to talk about fragrances that some people don't talk about, but I also just love how relatable she is, kind of like Smurfy Girly. I feel like when I watch her videos, again, it's like I'm talking to my friends, or I'm talking to my sister or my mom, just about things that we love and about, you know, like, I like how she also has a mix of other things with her channel as well. It's not just fragrance, so it's nice to have a little bit of a break and see what her other likes are, what other things she recommends, what she got. I just really, really like that. I don't know, like, it's just like I recently, just like Smurfy Girly, got into her videos, and again, I think I binge watched all of them. So I just really love those as well. She's just, again, it's just refreshing to sit down and watch videos like that. Like, I love the vivacity of Vava Couture and the editing of Vava Couture. I love the passion of Tiff Benson and just how well, like, she sells fragrances on you or doesn't sell fragrances on you. It kind of takes you aback. I love Delicious Delights. I love Amy Lowe's perfume. I love them all. But there's just something really comforting and really awesome about Just Jell. And so she's been another recent favorite of mine. I know I got kind of weird when I'm talking about these guys, but overall, just in general, all of these people are fantastic assets to the fragrance community on YouTube. I think it's really important to, I don't want to say support each other. You can support whoever you want, but I mean, if you like fragrance reviews, these are fantastic people to check out, get into, fall in love with. I see a lot of you guys that comment on my channel commenting on their channel too, and that makes me so happy. I love seeing the community active and involved with everybody. It really makes me smile. So I did want to make this video and talk about all of my favorite fragrance, female fragrance reviewers. Now the next video of this I'm going to do, I don't know if I'm going to do it tomorrow or I might do it Thursday, I'm going to talk about my favorite male fragrance reviewers. Now again, those are going to be guys who review fragrances. These are my favorite female fragrance reviewers. And I kind of wanted to break this up because I think that the male fragrance community on YouTube is booming. It's booming. There's so many and they are amazing. And the female fragrance reviewers, I think even Tiff Benson did a video on it where she's like, where are all my girls at? And so I was going to do this video before, but I was going to do it with men and women, and I decided maybe I should break it up. Female reviewer community. So, I mean, if there's anybody on here that you love that I didn't mention, link them below. I love to watch other people's videos specifically about fragrances. So if there's anybody you think deserves recognition, your favorite female fragrance reviewer, a reviewer that you think I skipped over, link, please. Please link their channels below. Let me know about them. Let's let's check out our ladies. But this isn't just about like check out the girls. This is really just about the fragrance community, and I really just wanted to share some of my favorite reviewers, because that's kind of like, I talk about my favorite fragrances, I make lists for you guys, I give you guys recommendations on products, and I also want to give you guys people that I trust, because these are people who will make recommendations who I'll spend my money based on it. You know, I get excited for watching these videos, hopefully like you guys get excited for watching my videos, so I really wanted to create this video for you. So again, if there's anybody on this list you think I missed, anybody who you would like to recommend, again, let me know below. And I hope you enjoyed this list of my favorite female fragrance reviewers on YouTube. As always, if you like videos like this, remember to give it a thumbs up. It lets me know to continue doing videos like this. And also don't forget to subscribe, because it's free and I'm free. And I put out new videos every Monday through Friday and sometimes on the weekends as well. So I'll always have something for you to watch. In any case, I hope you guys are all happy and healthy and have a great day, month, year, whatever. And I will see you next time.